All right, Mr.Taliaferro, how's everybody doing out there? Breaking news, breaking news, breaking news, breaking news. I just watched the NBA draft lottery about 30 minutes to an hour ago. And ladies and gentlemen, I cannot believe I'm saying this. The New Orleans Pelicans have the number one pick in the 2019 NBA draft. Wow. Could this night have went any worse for a Boston Celtics fan? Yo, this has probably been the worst week in Boston Celtics sports history. You get eliminated in five games after winning game one in the Eastern Conference semifinals. The Memphis Grizzlies keep their pick, right? And then, because they get the number two pick, I'll talk about Memphis in an entirely different video. And then now you don't even have that leverage on the New Orleans Pelicans because they got the number one pick. We all know that Anthony Davis has demanded a trade out of New Orleans. One of the biggest Boston Celtic trade mechanisms was, look, we want to help you guys get more picks. If I'm the Pelicans, my whole position has changed now. I done went from the ugly duck to the beautiful, beautiful swan, all right? I don't even know if that just made sense, but now if I'm the New Orleans Pelicans, I want more. I want more of everything if they decide to trade Anthony Davis this summer at all. This is as big a basketball storyline we got. I'm going to do a video on the Knicks. I'm going to do a video on the Memphis Grizzlies, the Lakers, all that stuff. Let's start here with the Pelicans, though. Let's give them their credit. First off, the Pelicans fan base deserved this. They deserved it. They had so much misfortune. They're about to lose a former number one pick, right? Most likely. But at least they'll be bringing in a new one. All right, now, look, Zion, I know you had plans on maybe playing in your hometown of Chicago or going to Madison Square Garden to play in New York. You're going to be down south loving some of that good home-cooked meals, some of them good Mardi Gras, good old nice jumbo Goliath meals. All right, you are going to be in New Orleans no matter what. The Pelicans have now have all the leverage, right? If I'm thinking about this from the Anthony Davis perspective. I want so much now. If Anthony Davis, we don't know what he's going to do. Maybe he decides to say, okay, I want to stay around and give this thing two or three more years, right? Look how quickly things can trade in a few months, right? We don't know what Anthony Davis is going to do. Maybe this is Anthony Davis thinking to himself, okay, this is the final straw. I want out now. You guys got your new number one pick. Let me go ahead and leave. There are a multitude of directions the Pelicans and then Anthony Davis could be thinking today. I think Anthony Davis is still going to want out, but I do believe the Pelicans have a huge mechanism at their disposal. If the Knicks want to trade for Anthony Davis, they got to find a third partner now. They can't just make a trade. Like, you can't just give me your fourth pick when I already got number one, right? What if the Knicks are going to go get Kyrie Irving and Kevin Durant? Okay, they want to put as many pieces around these two superstar caliber players as possible. The fourth pick, trying to offer that to the Pelicans when they already got number one? Probably not going to get that deal done. Probably not going to get that deal done for Anthony Davis. They'll need someone else in regards to Boston if they want Anthony Davis. All right, what were you going to offer me? Boston, that Memphis Grizzlies pick? Y'all don't have that. They will get the Clippers pick. But so what are you going to offer me? Jaylen Brown, Gordon Hayward, that's it? Nah, we already got Zion. We'll take this thing slow with Zion and Jrue Holiday. We're fine on that. We got Julius Randle as well. Might have to trade him. We'll take this thing slow if that's all you guys are offering us. Nah, if you're the Pelicans, you now want everything from Boston because you got the leverage now. I want Jaylen Brown. I want Gordon Hayward. And I want Jason Tatum. All right? And I might make you guys do a sign of trade, and I might want Terry Rozier on top of all that. I might want Al Horford on top of all that. This has changed everything dramatically. The Pelicans went from the small fish in a pond to now the shark in the ocean, just like that, with a little ball going in their favor. The Pelicans now have leverage, something that organization can say they've had for quite some time. I don't know what Anthony Davis is planning on doing. Obviously, we're going to do a lot of videos on that, but their position just changed dramatically with that ball going in their favor. Congratulations to the New Orleans Pelicans. The number one pick will be going down to New Orleans, Louisiana. And I don't believe the Pelicans trade the number one pick. I don't believe there's an offer out there where they trade the number one pick and keep Anthony Davis. I just doubt it. Unless Anthony Davis say, I'll stay with you guys long term. I'll resign if y'all were able to trade the number one pick for a star. I don't believe he stays in New Orleans. I don't believe the Pelicans trade that pick. We'll see what happens, though. I'm super excited as a fan, and I'm out. I came from nothing, but I want everything God has for me. I interview celebrities. I talk sports. I still represent the culture.
I got the kids. who are now tuned in.
Tuned in.
Yo, we locked in right now,
Mr.Taliaferro.
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 Shout out to Mr.Taliaferro.
You're watching Mr.Taliaferro TV.
Mr.Taliaferro TV. Here with the Triple B's, you can't do nothing but win.